How do we track Santa Claus on Christmas Eve during his incredible journey around the world? In this video, I'm going to talk to you about some of the technologies that NORAD use to track Santa Claus and how you can keep an eye on Santa during his journey on Christmas Eve. Hi there, and you're very welcome to another episode of The Superhero Scientist. I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, The Superhero Scientist. And in this video, I'm going to be talking to you about the technologies that we are using to keep track of Santa Claus during his incredible journey on Christmas Eve. Santa Claus has an extraordinary night ahead of him on Christmas Eve as he aims to deliver presents all around the world. But how do we keep track of Santa Claus on Christmas Eve? That's a really difficult thing that we need to figure out and try to solve. But fortunately for us, there is an organization that already does this, and that is NORAD. NORAD tracks Santa, and you can also follow this on Christmas Eve. You may be wondering what NORAD is or who NORAD are. Well, NORAD stands for the North American Aerospace Defense. It's an organization that was founded or is run by the United States of America and Canada, and it's a military organization that is used to keep track of military interests in terms of anything that's in the air or flying around the planet, in particular anything that's approaching North America. There are a number of locations in North America, with the headquarters being in Colorado Springs. But how does NORAD track objects? What I'm going to do here is I'm going to talk about two of the different technologies that NORAD uses to track objects that are flying around the planet. Now, this is the first approach. Here is the planet Earth, and as many of you may already know, we have a number of satellites in orbit around planet Earth. NORAD has a system of satellites which is called the Space-Based Infrared System, and this is a series of satellites that can detect infrared signatures. You may be wondering, what is infrared and how do we keep track of these signatures, as they're called? The first thing you need to know is that we can't see infrared. Infrared, in fact, is a form of electromagnetic radiation, just like light. Our eyes can see light, but our eyes are not able to detect infrared signatures. The next question you might be asking is, what exactly is an infrared signature? Well, the thing is this, anything that is warm or hot gives off an infrared signature. You are a source of infrared radiation or an infrared signature. A cup of tea is also a source of infrared radiation or an infrared signature. And missiles are also a source of an infrared signature. NORAD uses this technology to detect if missiles have been launched from one part of the world towards another, and they're able to detect these missiles because they can pick up the heat that is emitted by the rockets on the back of the missiles. In terms of keeping track of Santa Claus, NORAD are not going to be looking at heat signatures from a rocket on the back of the sleigh, because in fact, Santa is a very environmentally friendly delivery person and is not using rocket technologies to get around the world. In fact, they will be using the technology to detect Rudolph's red nose, because as that glows, it gives off a very strong infrared signature that the satellites can actually measure. Another approach used by NORAD is called radar, and radar stands for radio detection and ranging. In this case, radar uses radio waves. Radio waves are another form of electromagnetic radiation. Again, our eyes cannot see radio waves, and that is why we need special antennas or dishes to be able to measure and detect radio waves. How does radar actually work? Well, to explain how radar works, I'm going to jump into an explainer. Now, a change of view. As you can see, I'm up in the sky, a little bit unusual. Don't worry, I'm not actually floating or flying or anything like that. This is the explainer to get into the details on radar. Now, to start in relation to radar, we need a radio antenna. And there we have it. This is the antenna that will be emitting radio waves and then also receiving them after they have reflected or bounced off an object of interest. You might be wondering why I've gone with a blue sky, because Santa Claus normally delivers presents at night when it's dark. Well, the main reason is that it's easier to actually see everything with a blue sky as opposed to a dark sky with stars, and that's the reason. What happens is the following. The station, in this case the radar station, is emitting radio waves, hoping that those radio waves will hit something and bounce off it. At some point during the day, or during the night in this case, radio waves will be emitted towards the sky and will actually interact with something that's moving. In this case, Santa Claus. The radio waves will hit Santa Claus, bounce off of Santa Claus, they don't do anything bad to him, and they'll be reflected back towards the radio antenna. The reflected signal can then be used to give information on Santa Claus's speed, his direction, and other important factors you will need to know in relation to his path and his trajectory on Christmas Eve. And that's where these radar images come from, something like this. And one of those dots on the image could in fact be Santa Claus and his sleigh. And that's how radar can be used to keep track of Santa Claus when he enters the airspace of certain countries on Christmas Eve. And there you have an explanation of how radar works. But why does NORAD track Santa Claus? There are a number of good reasons. First of all, NORAD wants to protect Santa Claus so that somebody doesn't mistake him for a rocket or a missile. And NORAD shares this information with the entire world so that no countries mistakenly fire a rocket at Santa Claus. Secondly, they want to be able to warn Santa Claus about other aircraft in his vicinity and also warn aircraft that Santa Claus is going to be flying by them very, very soon. And finally, NORAD can also use their technologies to help in the detection of very dangerous weather fronts, so lots of rain or lots of snow, and they can relay this information to Santa Claus and his central control in the Arctic Circle, who can then decide on how they can change Santa Claus's route on Christmas Eve. And there you have it. That's how NORAD keeps track of Santa Claus on Christmas Eve. They use two main technologies: infrared satellites to measure the heat given off by Rudolph's red nose, and the second approach is using radar to keep track of Santa Claus when he's entering airspace of different countries. It's truly brilliant technologies used to help the world keep track of Santa Claus on his incredible journey on Christmas Eve. And you can join in the tracking, because NORAD tracks Santa. You can visit that website on Christmas Eve and keep an eye on Santa's journey around the world. Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this video in relation to NORAD and Santa Claus. If you want to know more about the secret science of Santa Claus, you can do two things. First of all, you can get a hold of my book, Secret Science of Santa Claus, at bwscience.com. Or, of course, you can subscribe to this channel, where I'll be putting up more videos in relation to the incredible science behind what Santa Claus achieves on Christmas Eve. I've been Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist. Thanks for joining me for this video, and stay tuned for more scientific videos about Santa Claus and superheroes. They'll be online very soon. And in the meantime, always think super.